Hello friends, we will see the Z transform, how to calculate it. Equation for the Z transform can be written like this, and inverse Z transform can be written like this. In the program, we have declared this x randomly. So the 7 values of x will be declared randomly. The maximum will be 9. We had plotted it. Let's see how it looked like. Now this is our original signal. When we need to calculate a Z transform, our n should go from 0 to n minus 1. But in MATLAB, no matrix can start with the 0. It has to start with the 1. So the range will be from 0 to n. So what will happen with this n? So the initial value should be 0. Instead of that, it is becoming 1. So what we need to do is that instead of n, we need to write as n minus 1 so that it will start with the 0. Let's see how it reflects in the program. This is the equation. The xk can be written as, this is in the time domain, x signal, and it is multiplied with exponential of I w k minus 1. So this is actually n minus 1. This is the k value. Okay, now we need to have some values of omega. So this omega is been taken as 0.2 pi. It is like this. Let's see the how the output of the Z transform look like. This output will be only magnitude part. So we had taken the real part of this x. This is the output of Z transform. Now while calculating the inverse Z transform, we had did the same thing. K goes from 1 to n, and here instead of minus j we need to write plus j, and this is the inverse Z transform. Okay, the output of this inverse Z transform should be same that of the initial signal. Here we can see that it is near about same. Let's check the command window. In the command window you can see that this is 8, this is 8, this is 9, this is 9, this is 2, this is 2, 6, 9, 9, 6, 6, 1, 1, and 3, and 3. So the output is same. Thank you.